back down.
LeBron is obviously the phony goat, but now it's time for a legit greatest of all time. It's time for Wayne's World. Time for Lil Wayne, as always, on Fridays at 11:30 Eastern. Good morning, goat. And by the way, you are in New York, and I think you just had an earthquake, right?
I think we did too. Yes, yes.
Wow.
I think we did.
And did it shake? Where are you? In a hotel? Did it shake the building?
I don't know. Yeah, it did. It shook the building a little bit. Yes, it did.
Well, now that you live in L.A., you're used to earthquakes, right?
I'm used to it. Everybody was texting me, did you feel this? I'm like, yeah, y'all all right? You know, we do this.
Oh, we do this? Okay.
We do this.
Okay. So, Wayne, I did hate it for you that your LSU lost to Caitlin Clark in Iowa. We all sitting here at this table picked LSU. I still think your team was better, but big news yesterday was that your point guard, who did guard Caitlin Clark for most of the game, will transfer. So, Wayne, how much was Haley Van Lith to blame for the loss to Iowa?
Oh, no, I don't blame her at all.
Okay.
Not at all. Any position she was put in, you know, that's the coach's position. You know, that's the coach's decision, so
yeah,
I don't blame
her. Fact.
And also, you can see the effort. She tried her heart out. That's just Caitlin Clark. You can't do too much about that.
Yeah, you can't blame. You cannot blame her or even put blame in her name in the same sentence. I've heard a couple people say, oh, I'm like, well, wait a minute. Kim Mulkey is the one who drew up the defense.
She did.
The young lady is out there with maximum effort. Caitlin Clark been cooking everybody.
Everybody.
So, come on.
Yeah, that's definitely on the coaches. I mean, she's average. She leads the nation in scoring. You can't play her one-on-one. I mean,
exactly.
They started off the game. I looked the first play of the game. They went under the screen. And then they did it again. So that made me think, was that the game plan?
Yeah.
You know, sometimes it comes to, like, ego coaching. Like, look, this is our defense. You play against this set defense. We've been playing this defense all year. It don't matter who we play against, we're going to continue to play this
way.
And they got burned.
Yep. So, Wayne, I opened the show that morning after with just that point. And I'm a fan of Kim Mulkey, but that was almost like arrogant on her part to say, we are the defending champs. We're LSU. We play defense the way we play defense. We don't care if it's Caitlin Clark or Susie Clark. We're going to come out here with our point guard, and she's going to play Caitlin Clark. Well, Haley Van Lith, as you know, Wayne, was at Louisville a year ago. They made it to the Final Four because of her, but she was up score. She averaged 21 a game for Louisville, okay?
Yes.
Then she says, okay, I want to join forces with the best, the defending champs. I want to go play point guard for an ultimate point guard in Kim Mulkey. And I will sacrifice my scoring. I think she averaged 11 a game this year. And I'll try to figure out how to pass the basketball. I don't think she's a gifted point guard. But I'm guessing that she took so much, I'll just say, grief on social media over she was the reason that they lost, that she just said, I'm out. I just can't take this anymore.
It's probably a lot of that. Also, I said she walked into the situation and probably wasn't able to handle all the stuff that come with playing with LSU.
That's a lot.
She walked into a lot, you know. And also, I don't know if you remember, you know, all this started from her. Not she didn't do it, but you remember Caitlin did it to Haley the game before she played Angel.
No, she did.
Yeah, that's where
true.
It came from. But I thought it was interesting that Haley joined Angel and that they actually met up.
Well, that's interesting.
And they played Caitlin. I thought that was interesting.
Well, actually, Caitlin started the "you can't see me" the Cena thing.
Haley.
She did it to Van Lith.
Haley Van Lith. Yes, right? That's what I said. Yeah,
and that's why Angel did it back to Caitlin after they won.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I've been trying to look up to find out if she's actually a fifth-year senior. Or a six-year COVID senior that's a graduate.
Ooh, Van Lith.
Yeah, Van Lith. Haley, is that the reason that she's transferring again from LSU?
I don't know. I think she's got an extra COVID year, I think. I was a little surprised she just didn't go into the WNBA draft. But
exactly.
Yeah.
Man,
okay.
The transfer portal is so crazy,
crazy,
right? I mean, this is like, it's like NBA or something. You could be at three schools in the 3 years. Yes. It's got to be some type of penalty to where when you transfer, you miss like the first 10 games because if people don't like their situation, they just go to another school, whereas before you missed the whole year. Yeah. And I don't agree with missing the whole year, but it should be a penalty to that. And that's why recruitment is so difficult nowadays because of the transfer portal and the NIL situation. So I don't know how to solve this situation. I mean, you just when you're just not feeling comfortable in a situation, you just get up and run. Maybe the grass is greener on the other side. I just don't get it.
Sure. Yeah. Hey, man. I'm not sure if it was Saban that said it, but one of those coaches said it was like one of the new roles of being a football coach today for college football is you also have to so you got to recruit throughout the whole year now. Like, you have to recruit that player. You got to make sure you got to try to recruit them to stay.
Yeah. You better have deep pockets.
Yeah, you got to actually recruit in the transfer portal. And
exactly.
So you can really just focus on the transfer portal. You know, I think that's what Deion, really did.
Yeah, exactly.
You know.
So Wayne, are you surprised at how popular and hot women's college basketball has become, that we're all looking forward to the women's Final Four much more than the men's? Are you surprised by that?
Not surprised at all, Skip, just because everything is getting better. But if you haven't been watching on social, watching online, watching what they've been able to accomplish, not on just checking them, the dribbles out, the handles out, all that's different when it comes to the women. You had Fran from Stanford dunking already. You know, I know like five females that's dunking already. I don't even know if they're in the WNBA yet. So it's like, you know what I mean? It's like it's about to be crazy.
The women's skill sets are way different than back in the day. They're better. Yeah. They're just better. Their skills are better. They doing things that the men game is doing. Like, they Euro-stepping. They weren't doing that back then.
Hey, Juju Watkins, she was Euro-stepping the other night. I was impressed.
One too many ties.
Well, maybe.
You know, in all actuality, I'm going to tell y'all this. As a hooper, like, when I watch today's game, and I used to tell this to kids, I'm talking about 10 years ago, I say, listen, watch the women's game more than the men's. And you know why? The women are way more fundamentally sound than the men because they lack the athleticism, where us as men, we get by sometimes on athleticism. Mm-hmm. But if you actually sit and watch the women, they're way more fundamentally sound in everything they do. It's a purpose with every move and everything they create. Because when you're athletic, you just dribble, put your head down and go up 1-2 and you're in the air. But the women, I said this before this time now, that I used to study the women game because my game is sort of like how the women play. I wasn't the most athletic player, but I was very fundamentally sound. Mm. And I seen that in a lot of the women's game that you don't see quite anymore in the men's because it's not being taught at a younger age.
Interesting. So
also, the center is still valuable in the women's game.
Mm.
Yes, you still have post play. You still have, pivots, jab steps. Just the fundamentals are there. I watch these trainers now, Skip. I'm around Los Angeles in the summer. I go to the gyms, and they're teaching stuff that I'm like, start with the basics. Like, if you don't have the base of the fundamental, how you even get to that? And so now I'm seeing kids do these moves, and it's not working. Mm. It's like they premeditated moves that don't work. And so we got to get back to the basics. And a start would be check out these women's games.
Yeah.
Check them out.
So
because
Wayne,
they're more fundamentally sound.
Will Caitlin Clark and Iowa win it all tomorrow and tonight and Sunday?
No, I have South Carolina.
Do you?
Yeah.
Why?
Ms. Dawn, plain and simple.
She is something.
Yeah, also I think Ms. Dawn got it on her mind. She lost against Caitlin.
I
don't think she's trying to go 2 years with this 72-1 or 72-2.
That's incredible.
I don't think she's trying to go, do it and not get the chip.
Yeah, they are South Carolina prohibitive favorites. So do you think Caitlin will get by UConn and then lose to South Carolina?
I don't know, because, Paige Buckets, she's showing up. And she's
Keyshawn likes her.
She's been a beast.
Paige Buckets.
Yeah, Paige Buckets is right.
Paige Buckets.
Yeah. All right.
enough of that. We got to get Wayne's thoughts on what just broke.
You already know he's going. If that's a decision he make, he's going to the NBA. You ain't got to worry about that.
Okay. And what would it mean to you as a Laker fan to see LeBron and Bronny on the court at the same time?
Me as a basketball fan, as a fan of sports, and also as a father, and as a father of three sons, period. What? What? I've already, you know, my beautiful daughter, she's the oldest, just already got to, you know, live out certain experiences with her. And just to see LeBron James on a court with Bronny and actually playing in a real game, that, come on now, come on. That would be so motivating to any father around the world, any man, any female, any, that's just motivation, period. That's family on the court. That's family on the court. You can't explain that no better than that.
You know, if whether or not it's with the Lakers or another NBA team, much like Wayne is saying, it would be a sight to see. I mean, obviously, yes. We saw it in baseball with Griffey and his father. I don't remember it. Bonds no. missed. Yeah,
we so didn't play we together, saw, but, yeah. but Bobby was always there.
Yeah, Bobby was always there. But we saw.
Didn't he play in the All Star game?
Yeah, I guess he did.
May have. We've seen Griffey and them do it, right? Yeah. That's the one that comes to mind. Mm-hmm. But for LeBron, whether it's the Lakers or somewhere else, if the Lakers ultimately pass on the opportunity, it, much like Paul Pierce seems to think that the Lakers dynasty you didn't call it dynasty, you called it era of winning a championship would be over with this year if they for somehow don't get there.
If they don't make the playoffs.
If they don't make the playoffs, that it's over with, then for LeBron to say, or the Lakers to say, we get ready to blow this whole thing up and start afresh, and for LeBron to take his talents on the road again, and that particular organization would acquire his son via the draft or free agency, I'm all with it. Whatever he needs to do to play with his son, I bless it.
Mm. Yeah, LeBron stated he wanted to play with him. But as I sit back and really think about the situation, you know, as a young man trying to make your own name and grow up, he may come to a decision to say, no, you know what, I want to be on a different team.
Too late.
I want to be on a different team.
Too late.
Oh, but think about this, Keith. Wait, think about this. We would love to see LeBron get the rebound, kick it ahead, or throw it lob to Bronny. But what about this scenario where you got Bronny James Jr. on the right isolation wing against his dad?
Check up,
right? I think I may want to see that. I want to see if he can get a bucket on his dad or something. I think so. Either way you look at it, I think it's a win-win. I mean, it's going to be a national televised game either way. If he's with the Lakers, he's going to play some. He's not going to play some based on where the team is at and how they're doing. But wouldn't it be nice to say, all right, Bronny James, clear out the right side. Dad, check up. Let's go get it. I might want to see that.
And then Dad might say, don't worry about it. He with us.
Think about that, though. I might want to see that even more than them playing together.
So, Wayne, you've been around Bronny. I only know him from a distance, and I've said many times on television, this kid was born with an extreme burden. He was LeBron James Jr., and no kid could have ever handled that expectation, that responsibility, lived up to it the way this kid had. He is so mature beyond his years. He is ready to play pro basketball alongside or even opposite his father. However that may be, he can handle it. He can live up. That's the young man you've seen, right, Wayne?
Oh, it's also, too, I've heard you speak about his defense, and his defense is crazy.
I believe he does.
Yeah. And also, he's a hustler, too, Skip. Mm-hmm. He's one of those guys that just plays hard. You know, like, those guys last long in any league. He just plays hard.
Yeah, and when we saw him 1 year ago in the McDonald's game, he was making spot-up threes. I think he made three big ones in the second half, and then he goes to Keyshawn School, and he forgets how to shoot the three. But he was coming off his heart condition. He only shot 27% from three. But I promise you, as a pro basketball player, especially if he's alongside his father, if his father kicks it to him for an open three, he'll make those threes. That's just what he does. Yeah,
that'll be fun. That'll be good for the league.
I forgot about the heart situation. He's also a brave young man.
He's a brave young man.
Out there. Yeah.
Yeah. So, Wayne, would you attend more Laker games if it became Bron and Bronny?
What? Well, my son's right there with me.
Ooh, he would be. You know, Cam.
Yeah, you already know.
He would already know. So, quick thought on the Lakers that you see right here, right now. Are you projecting them to at least get to the Western Conference Finals?
Yeah, it's going to be Lakers versus Phoenix in the finals.
Phoenix? Whoa. Yeah. So, yeah. Phoenix is going to get Denver?
Ooh. Yeah.
Really? Why is that?
I think they meshing at the right time, and I think they playing possum right now. They're hearing what everybody's saying about. They thought it was gonna be this, and they thought it was gonna be that. I think they about to show it what it's gonna really build. I think they get it all together. I like everything about it.
Wait. If Golden State plays the Lakers in the play-in, the 9th, 10, who you got? Who you think comes out of that?
Serious,
huh? Don't even ask.
Golden State is rolling right now, though.
He's trying to figure out how to
right now,
get rid of LeBron and the Lakers.
I ain't say that. I'm saying right now they're both in the 9th.
Say it.
That's the 9th, and that's the play-in spot right there today. So if they play each other, the way Golden State is playing and the way Lakers is playing, you think the Lakers get past Golden State to make...
I love you, man.
No, I'm saying.
Anything to disrespect.
Curry is rolling. Clay's back in the starting lineup. Draymond looking like Draymond. And that young kid over there, what's the young kid that's ducking everything now? Jackson?
Yeah.
Man, they looking nice.
Paul, you just fear the Lakers against the Celtics. That's what you fear.
No, we definitely don't fear that.
You literally have tried to discount the Lakers and LeBron.
I just said.
Since you started the show.
I just asked if the Lakers played the Warriors, who you got? Because I'm looking at the Warriors, and I look at the Lakers. They both playing well, and I don't know. I don't know anymore. I'm confused.
I'm going with the team with the better player.
Who got the better player?
LeBron's the better player.
Than Curry?
Right now? Right. He's 40 years old.
I don't know about that.
Thanks for watching, Undisputed fans. Do you want more highlights from the show? Make sure to click that subscribe button for all the exclusive content from Undisputed.